Judd is dead. Poor Judd Fry is dead. All gather round his coffin now and cry. He had a heart of gold, and he wasn't very old. Oh, why did such a feller have to die? Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. He's looking oh so peaceful and serene. He's all laid out to rest, with his hands across his chest. His fingernails have never been so clean. And then a preacher would get up and he'd say, "Folks, we are gathered here to moan and groan over our brother Judd Fry, who hung himself up by a rope in the smokehouse." And then I'd be weeping and wailing from some of them women. He said, "Judd was the most misunderstood man in the territory, and people used to think he's a mean, ugly feller, and they called him a dirty skunk and an ornery pig stealer. The folks that really knowed him know that beneath them two dirty shirts he always wore, there beat a heart as big as all outdoors.
As big as all outdoors.
Judd Fry loved his fellow man.
He loved his fellow man.
He loved the birds of the forest and the beasts of the field. He loved the mice and vermin in the barn, and he treated the rats like equals, which was right. And he loved little children. He loved everybody and everything in the world. Only he never let on, so nobody ever noticed. Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. His friends will weep and wail for miles around. The daisies in the dell will give out a different smell, because poor Judd is underneath the ground.
Poor Judd is dead, a candle lights his head. He's laying in a coffin made of wood.
Wood.
And folks are feeling sad, 'cause they used to treat him bad, and now they know their friend is gone for good.
Good.
Poor Judd is dead, a candle lights his head.
He's looking oh so pretty and so nice. He looks like he's asleep. It's a shame that he won't keep, but it's summer. Yeah.